Hello, everybody. I am Mold West, and this is Near Automata once again. We got something going on.
This is the current status of Unit 9S.
Affirmative. His mental state has become dangerously unstable. Action must be taken immediately.
Yes. He's not doing so hot. And now it's forcing me to monitor Unit A2 instead of 9S because story reasons. And that was the plan anyway, alternate between 9S and A2. It appears A2's memory region... A2's memory region has combined with 2B's data, currently monitoring progress, to analyze effect. Hold, pod 042. Issue detected in your conversational functionality. Numerous machine lifeforms whose network functions were destroyed remain out of control. Please take caution. Affirmative. Yes. Pods just podding back and forth. Now anyway, what's A2 up to? Taking a nap in the desert, that's what.
Good morning, A2.
What the...
Analysis. Your high unit A2 was restarted 5 minutes and 42 seconds ago. The cause was excessive strain due to battle against a large machine life form.
Yeah.
This goddamn sand is starting to piss me off.
It's rough, it's coarse, and it gets everywhere.
Filter performance deteriorating. Fine particulate matter seems to have entered the filter while fighting in the desert. Proposal. Replace the faulty part immediately.
You make it sound so easy.
Records indicate said part was once used at the resistance camp.
The resistance camp.
So yeah, we gotta get to the resistance camp so that we can do thing. We gotta do the thing that we gotta do out there. And maybe it'd be faster getting there if we were to warp using the thingamajig over here instead of walking all the way across the goddamn desert to do it. Would you little bastards please refrain from smashing up the shit that I need to use to go doing stuff? Now, transport to resistance camp! There we go. Given the context of the story, it doesn't make much sense that A2 would be able to use those since she defected from Yorha, but now, from a gameplay standpoint, it makes a whole lot of sense to let you use it, because that would be infuriating. Anyway, resistance camp. And... not you... Not you. Fuck, who am I supposed to talk to? Did it fully expect me to walk here from the fucking desert? Yeah, it did, because there's fucking objective marker. Oh!
Help! Help me!
Pascal's in trouble. Don't you worry, Pascal! A2 to the rescue, saving your sorry robo-ass! Because I'm just that kind of android. I like saving people from hostile-ass machines. There you go. Stop wailing on Pascal. I'm gonna fuck your shit up, mister.
Thank you so much for saving me.
You're a machine, too.
Wait, please. I have no intention of harming you. My name is Pascal. And while it's true that I am a machine life form...
to test
fighting of any kind.
Pacifist, gotcha.
And machines don't have souls. They're just murder bots with a fancy name. They killed so many of us. And I swore to make them pay.
I see. If that will save your soul, then so be it.
I ain't gonna kill Pascal. I like Pascal.
You aren't going to kill me?
Just shut up and leave before I change my mind.
You.
Me.
No. Never mind. You have my thanks.
Oh. Bye, Pascal. Killing him wouldn't make any difference, though. He's got, like, an extra body back in his village that he just beams his consciousness into. Might lose a few bits of data here and there, but... Eh, it's the price you pay for being a fucking robot. Number two, you're still alive? Sorry, I haven't been in touch, Anemone. You survived, that's all that matters. Though I fear that all of your fighting companions are long gone. I had to kill number 21 with my own hands. I'm sorry. No, it's... Oh, that's right. Did you know there was a Yorha member here named 2B that looked just like you? She's dead. What? 2B is dead. I killed her. She was infected with a logic virus. Oh. And with the bunker gone, she don't get an extra body anymore. Well, please make yourself at home in our camp. I'll have someone show you a route. Not necessary. Her memories are contained in this sword. I see. You can go ahead and use her old room then. I'm in charge of the camp here. I'll make sure to tell everyone about you. So yeah, you do that. I need the fuel filter. Got a question for you. Any chance to spare a filter? I'm afraid our supply recently ran out. Pascal makes them for us, so you can go pick one up directly if you'd like. Pascal, you know him? You trade with the enemy? His village is different. They never caused us any harm. No way, forget it. This may be hard to understand, but we forge an alliance and trade materials when the need arises. We can't be picky about how we reach our goals around here. And besides, we aren't so far gone that we kill machine lifeforms after they surrender. So, yeah.
A broken filter will cause significant problems with fuel distribution.
Good to know.
Proposal. Replace the faulty part immediately.
Working on it!
I know.
Coordinates confirmed for a colony centered around the machine lifeform known as Pascal. Location marked on map.
Yeah, I already know where the village is.
Shut up, do you?
Yeah, you keep on talking, Pascal's village, which I can't warp to... But I can, however, go to a place that's real close to it, and then run from there.
There's machines everywhere.
Yep, analysis. It's their village.
This is a colony of pacifistic machine lifeforms led by the unit known as Pascal.
Yep.
It is logical for a large number of machine lifeforms to be present. This
yep.
bug has concerns regarding Yorha Unit A2's predictive skills.
I'd be more concerned about me smashing your face if I were you.
So yeah, Pod needs to learn how to not be a condescending little bastard while I go swap out this fuel filter.
Ah, it's the woman from before. Thank you again for rescuing me.
Give me a fuel filter.
Now then, how can I help you?
Summary. Yorha Unit A2 possesses a faulty fuel filter. She has obtained information from Anemone, leader of the Resistance camp. She has traveled to this village in order to obtain a new filter. End summary. Request. One functional fuel filter.
Do you really need to spell it all out like that?
Analysis. A2's lack of verbal communication made this pod's assistance necessary.
Shut up.
Ah, I see. Sadly, I'm a bit short on materials right now. I need rigid tree bark to create a filter, but the only location I know of is guarded by ferocious machine lifeforms. Apologies, but I'm afraid I can't make a filter at the moment.
Confirmation. Unit A2 will secure and deliver rigid tree bark.
Don't confirm that by yourself.
Areas where rigid tree bark is available marked on map.
God damn it.
Analysis.
Yep, fetch quest.
Hostility toward the peaceful machine lifeform Pascal is pointless from an energy usage standpoint. Proposal. Form a friendly relationship immediately.
You've got to be kidding me.
I don't think the pod is capable of kidding you. Anyway, where would I find rigid tree bark? There's too many fucking quest objectives showing up here, probably out in the forest. Yeah, that says current destination, doesn't say shit about rigid tree bark. Yeah, that's mysterious letter. Fucking, You are a mysterious letter. Oh yeah, I got that fucking mail thing that gave me a bunch of random ass coordinates, but yeah, I would assume it's in the goddamn forest. That does seem like a good place to go getting rigid tree bark, and I don't see how tree bark gets used in the making of a fuel filter. But who am I to question the wisdom of a fucking damn robot? Okay, now they're seeking revenge against the right person. There's no humans, we're all androids. And yeah, A2 did kill your king, so yeah, you're right to seek revenge against her. Instead of flailing around at 9S like you were before. And that's a whole lot of robots. Like, so many of them. Maybe I could just charge up some ow lasers and blast a few of you away. And, alright, need some breathing room while I do my healy things. There we go. Ow. Why must there be so many of you? Y'all are fucking everywhere, and I'm running low on large recoveries. That ain't good. This wouldn't be such a big problem if I were a higher level, but I am not. And since I ain't 9S at the moment, I can't just hack into all of you. So we're doing this the old-fashioned way, running around, charging up lasers, and firing wildly into the crowd. There we go, that took out some of them. Yeah. Now we're doing this. A couple of them got shields, but that's fine. All right, another one down. Ooh, goddamn. Why must y'all be so mean like that? I need my fucking lasers, but it fucking coolie down time. There you go. There we go. The problem is being solved, and machines are being destroyed one by one. So, into the crowd goes the lasers, and hey, don't you spin your little buzzsaw around like that. Eat a dirk, mister. There's a level up. That's exactly what I need. Now, were those the ferocious machine life forms Pascal mentioned? This is probably one of them. It does seem rather ferocious and machine life for me. Hey. Quit walking around in circles. I'm trying to slash up your kneecaps. Get out of the way, pig. I'm trying to see the big robot dude. Ooh, boy. He's a stomping real good. Up spear guy showing up where he isn't wanted, needing to learn his fucking place. So, here, why don't I teach you your place by way of fucking lasers? There you go. Triple lasers for you. Cut you down in no time. Where'd the big guy go? There'd the big guy go. He went over there. Now, why are you still walking in circles? Hold still. I want to smash your teeth in. Do robots even have teeth? Actually, they do. We seen in an earlier episode when they started going fucking nuts after we took down fucking Adam. And they started eating fucking androids and other machines going full zombie bot. Anyway, he's dead. Now, did you happen to have that rigid tree bark I needed? You had a stripped screw, that's what you had. There we go, rigid tree bark.
Guess I'll go back to that machine.
Yeah, we're gonna go back to Pascal and we're gonna cram some tree bark into my circuits. That'll fix my fuel problem. Here's the tree bark you needed.
Thank you so much.
So this part's voice acted, but it wasn't before.
Please just give me one moment.
And he's gone.
He can fly?
You watched him fly after you saved him.
Alert. The machine life form Pascal has returned.
No shit. And we got ourselves a fuel filter. And now my option is to my objective is to thank Pascal.
A2, can I help you with something?
You gave me that filter for free earlier. I need to pay you back. It would bother me otherwise.
How conscientious
of you.
Yeah, so if you think of something, let me know. I do have a bit of a problem now that you mention it.
Nope, later, bye.
A ferocious machine has been attacking our children in the area where they play. Could I possibly trouble you to slay it for us? I do hope you'll agree, we don't really have anyone else to ask.
Fine.
Thank you so much. I promise to repay you for the trouble.
Vanquish the bad bot. That's what I'm gonna go ahead and do. Gonna kill me another fucking robo-turd. Right down here. Now, how bad could you be? Okay. So you're one of those fancy paint job guys that's more dangerous than the regular dudes. That's fine. But you don't seem to be extra durable like some of the other ones I've seen. And you're done. And now you explode. I'm gonna take this thing and that thing. Some titanium alloy, always good to have. And we will report back to Pascal, tell him that we just killed the robot, even though he just watched us do it. In the next episode, to the moment of time for this one. So thank you all so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed watching. I hope to see you again in the next one. Bye.